Here is a big book with really big ideas, so I'm giving our overview in two parts. This scripture snapshot will cover just the first five chapters. We'll need special help from God to understand Romans, but when we do, we'll never be the same. This is God's explanation of salvation and how he can transfer his righteousness to us while still being right himself. What is salvation? It's everything God has for us in Christ. This book shows us that while enjoying the gospel requires only a simple act of taking God at his word, what the Bible calls faith, understanding the gospel and all it contains will be a lifelong exploration through a vast new world of divine treasures which are offered to us only by grace. One key to understanding Romans is to grasp the vocabulary of the book. If we're learning to cook, it's good to know the difference between boiling and broiling. Learning to drive involves understanding the difference between the accelerator and the brake. So we need to know what Paul means by words like law, sin, grace, faith, the flesh, and the spirit, and so on. Vine's expository dictionary of Bible words is very helpful for this kind of study. In chapters 1 through 3, verse 20, the case for the righteousness of God and the unrighteousness of all humanity is presented. The righteousness of God has been revealed, so we're without excuse. In fact, we're inexcusable because we're condemned by our inborn knowledge of God, by sinful acts we do against our conscience, by our condemnation of others for the sins we ourselves commit, and by the light we have from either natural or revealed laws from God. Guilty as charged, and the sentence is death, meaning separation from God forever. So what can be done about this? Paul now shows in 3:21 through chapter 4:25 that to be justified means to be declared right by God. But we can't be justified by law-keeping, good works, or religious activities. Paul uses the example of Abraham, a sinful man who became the personal friend of God through faith. This is God's great desire, that we be his friends as well. But how? We all fall short of God's standards. Claiming our own merit puts us in the ridiculous position of suggesting that our efforts put God into our debt. No, Paul explains, we can only be saved by accepting as a gift God's undeserved grace through faith, when our heart says yes to his truth. We mustn't only agree with God that our personal sin is the problem, but also that Christ's death for us is the only answer, plus nothing. Romans 5:8 declares, God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5 presents the wonderful benefits of being justified by faith, peace with God, access by faith into God's resources for living this new life in victory, called sanctification, certain hope of our complete transformation, called glorification, God's love poured through our lives into this needy world, and so much more. See the five much more statements in the rest of chapter 5. Then see the scripture snapshot of Romans part 2 for much more of this amazing book.